You are probably watching this video on a computer. At first glance, a computer may seem like a real load of complicated gobbledygook, what with all its gibberish code and menacing circuitry, but at its most basic level, a computer is really just billions of little cleverly placed switches, which are called transistors. These switches have one job, to continue or block the flow of electricity, actions represented by the data values 1 and 0 respectively. These data values are called bits. To make better computers over the years, scientists have been trying to squeeze more and more transistors into microchips. Transistors are now tiny, measuring in nanometers, and as they shrink, we face a new problem. They're so small that normal, classical, Newtonian physics you learn in science class just doesn't apply. Instead, quantum physics rules the land, giving particles incredibly unintuitive properties. To keep up with the progress, we must reinvent the computer so as to work with quantum mechanics. This is known as quantum computing. Quantum objects are small particles like electrons, and one of the major properties they have is wave-particle duality. For the purpose of this video, this means these particles can be in more than one place or orientation at the same time, with certain probabilities of being in certain orientations and positions that are represented by a wave function. This state of multiple positions is known as quantum superposition, and it is what is mainly standing in the way of current progress in shrinking transistors. This is because if transistors are small enough, the wave function of an electron may be able to reach beyond the unopened transistor's barrier and pass through it, a process known as quantum tunneling. So, how are we going to tunnel our way through this problem? Well, what if we take these electrons and use them as data pieces? We can align them with a magnetic field and measure whether they yield to the magnet in a low-energy spin-down state or go against the magnet in a high-energy spin-up state. It's like transistors being open and closed. We now have 1 and 0 values. The difference is these electrons can also be in a superposition, with a certain probability of being 1 and 0 at the same time. When measured, it must collapse into one of those states, but it is not determined and is floating in probability land until then. Thus, we don't call these data pieces bits anymore, we call them quantum bits or qubits. Since a qubit in superposition is not in one definitive state at a given moment, it can be considered in both states at once. Put 2 qubits together, and there are 4 different states. Put 3, and there are 8. If you hadn't noticed by now, with every qubit you add, there's exponentially more computing power. To be specific, an n-qubit system potentially has the computing power of 2 to the n classical bits, which is insane. But it's not that simple. As stated earlier, at some point a qubit must be checked and lose its probability power. To take advantage of data with superposition, qubits have to be cleverly manipulated. Qubits are manipulated through quantum gates, which basically just take in an electron's superposition and output a new one. Another part of putting qubits to their full potential is a quantum property known as entanglement. When qubits are entangled, their superpositions are correlated, such that by measuring one, you can directly deduce properties of the other. This helps limit measurement and maximize probability power in the quantum computer. All this weird quantum manipulation might seem far off, but quantum computers are already here, developed by companies like IBM and D-Wave. While they're not fully universal quantum computers that can tremendously outdo our normal computers, they're signs of progress. Once quantum computers are developed in full, they will take on some of the bulkiest jobs in computing at unparalleled speed. We will see banks calculating financial risk and tech companies testing for computer bugs much more thoroughly than they do now. We will see spies evolving their methods to crack the encryption system that encode the world's secrets. We will see faster and better data handling in fields ranging from cancer research to space exploration. The information age will reach new heights with the birth of the quantum computer. It's gonna be amazing. Thanks for watching.